Hello friends, this lecture is in continuation with your lecture series of tractors and heavy earth moving machinery. We were discussing the unit number 3. In the unit number 3 we discussed in the last class the salient features of engine. I hope you have studied that, and now today we are going to discuss about a very important topic which is also used in other vehicles, that is clutch. Today we are going to discuss about the clutch, introduction, function of a clutch and types of clutch used in the tractors. Correct. Then there are what type of different clutches are available, friction, dog and fluid coupling is available. Then if I talk about a clutch, clutch is a device which engage and disengage the engine from the transmission gear and the drive wheels. Clutch transmit power by means of friction between driving members and driven members. This is the exploded view of your clutch. You can easily see there's a different parts. This is a friction plate which is actually in contact, which came in contact with your transmission shaft. That's why then the power can be transmitted from the engine to the wheels. Correct. So what are the functions? For cranking, the engine is disconnected from the rest of the transmission unit by a suitable clutch. Correct. For the starting, this clutch is required. The gearbox must be kept from the engine power, otherwise the gear teeth will be damaged and engagement of the gear will not be perfect. At the time of the engagement, we are advised to just leave the clutch slowly so that the engagement of the power from the engine to the rear wheel must be in homogeneous and without any jerk. Correct. So if the jerk is provided, then there is a possibility that your gear teeth will be worn off. Correct. The stopping of the belt pulley must be permitted without having to stop the engine. It means whenever you need, if you wanted to change the gear, otherwise if the clutch is not available, you cannot do it without stopping the engine. Correct. So clutch gives you an important way to just disengage and engage the new gear. Correct. Then the requirement of the clutch. What are the basic requirements? It should be good ability to taking load without dragging, grabbing and slipping. Correct. Without jerk even. Correct. It's a higher capacity to transmit maximum power without slipping, because if the slipping is there, then there is a loss of power. It should be convenient, accessible and easy to operate. Correct. The mechanical system or the system would be easier to operate. Friction surface would be highly resistant to heat effect. Heat effect means the heat should be dissipated earliest as possible and it should be homogeneously spreaded onto the surface. Then what are the types of clutch? We are discussing about the three major: friction, dog and fluid coupling. The friction clutch, if I talk about, in which the transmission takes place whenever the friction came into the in contact with this. As you see in this one, there is a driving member, there is a driven member. Correct. This one is the driving member and this one is the driven member. You can see over here, this is white in color. Correct. So whenever you press the clutch, it gets just disengaged. Correct. When you press it, it just gets disengaged. When you leave it, it just gets engaged. Correct. In that case means engaging and disengaging means when you press the clutch, your engine would get disengaged from your transmission. Correct. When you press the clutch, when you leave the clutch, correct, then it would be engaged with the engine. Correct. It would be engaged with the engine. Here, so you can see over here this plate. Correct. This plate, whenever you press this, this moves backward. This moves backward. So that's why this is getting free. Your transmission shaft gets free from the crankshaft. But when you leave it, this moves in the forward direction and gets engaged. Correct. This is how the friction would work, and due to the friction, both the plates would get stick to each other and moves and rotates. Correct. The transmission of the power depends upon the kind of material used for the friction number. So better quality of material should be used. So then the friction clutch is divided into three classes. There's a disc plate clutch, then the cone clutch. Then the disc plate is further of single and multiple plate clutch. Correct. You can say the single plate over here. There is only one plate is used, which is used the engagement and disengagement of the clutch with your flywheel. Correct. As you see in this case, when you pressing it, there is only one single plate. Can you see in here? There is one single plate which is getting engaged and disengaged with the flywheel with the help of your pressing. Correct. It consists of a pressure plate, clutch plate, spring, release fingers. These are the different parts name of it. So in this case, why it is called single plate? Because a single friction plate is used to transmit the power from your flywheel to the gearbox. Correct. Then there's a multiple plate. So you can say this is the exploded view of a multiplate. There are 1, 2, 3 plates are provided in between. Three friction plates are provided. That's why it is called multiplate, multiple plate clutch. So you can see in this image that there's two plates which are in use for it. Why we are using it? If the power transmission is so high, so instead of using the one single plate, which will be easier to wound off due to the high load. Correct. We are using the multiplates. Correct. That the flywheel rim does not serve as a friction surface. One set is attached to the flywheel and other set is attached to the clutch shaft. So the two sets are provided. Engagement and disengagement of this clutch is very smooth due to larger surface area of friction numbers. Correct. Nowadays many vehicles are using multiplate clutch. Correct. Single plate is earlier used was in the bikes or the scooters. Correct. Then we are having a cone clutch. Cone clutch is very important and very advanced kind of, you can see the, in the image, in the video also. Correct. In this cone clutch, you can see there's a cone is provided. A cone is provided on this cone. This is the inner core or the outer core. In the inner cone, the friction line is providing throughout the periphery, means 360 degree up shaft is provided. A lining is provided, which will give you enough surface area to engagement and disengagement. This is a driven shaft. This is a driving shaft. Correct. So without just pressing it, this cone, outer cone will be in connect with the inner cone through a friction line. Correct. Then the force is transmitted. The force is concentrated at a larger diameter. Correct. So it is concentrated on the larger diameter and having the enough surface area. Correct. Sufficient friction surface width is provided for the durability so that there is no slippages there. Correct. A full 360 degree of lining material is available. Correct. 360 degree means this lining is completely 360. It's a cut section view. Then this lining is 360 degree, as you can see in this video also. Correct. So you would see in here that how the friction cone clutch is working and how this friction plate is working in there. Friction lining is working in there. Okay. Then the next one is advantage of the friction clutches. The slips during engagement, they can be used as a high engagement speeds. This friction clutches, whenever there are higher loads, this gives you a window in which the engagement could be made smoother with a minimum shock. Correct. Other, if I would discuss with you the other type of clutches also in which the shock is there. Yeah. So the slip under momentary shock load provide cushioning. So the slip, if the loads are so high and jerky loads, correct, or shock loads, then this gives you a cushioning effect because there is some kind of slippage is provided. It just slips over. When it slips over, so there is no jerk would be there. It provides you the cushioning. Okay. Correct. Then we are having a dog clutch. This is kind of a very, very rugged kind of, or you can say there is no slippage in this kind of a dog clutch. And where it is required, there would be slippage is undesirable, where you do not want the slippage would be there. So on those cases, we are using the dog clutch. It is mostly used in the power tillers are which are carrying the load, heavier load. So we do not want that any kind of slippage would be there. So we want whenever we require, it should be able to carry the load. That's why we are providing the dog clutch. And you can say these are the gears are provided onto it. These are fixed into this, voids are provided, correct. So the power transmitted is completely there, completely, correct. Then we are having a fluid coupling, which is a very much kind of a new kind of a thing, but you cannot increase or decrease the thing. It will give you the same effect over there, correct. What is happening? A coupler is mounted on the engine crankshaft and it is 3/4 filled with the suitable oil. It is completely enclosed casing. It is a opened view, it's an enclosed casing. In the enclosed casing, the fluid is filled inside it, which is 3/4, 75% of the part. At the rotation of the crankshaft, the oil is thrown out from the centrifugal force. So from the one end, from the engine side, it is flown through the stirrer to your other side or the transmission side. Correct. It enters the runner at the outer portion and flows towards the center, providing the cushioning effect. Correct. So on the one side it is going outside and coming from the inwards. It goes to the periphery and comes out from the center. On the other hand, it enters from the center and out from the periphery. So it is both in a, working in a both direction. So it then enters a runner at the outer portion and flows towards the center, causing rotation to the runner unit. The coupling does not increase the applied torque, as I discussed. It does not increase or decrease the thing, but it transmits the torque in uniform manner. That's why the torque converter is made up of the fluid coupling. Correct. It cannot increase or decrease your value of the torque, but yes, it will give you the exact amount. The main feature of this is absorption of shock. So any shock, any fluid system can absorb the shock very easily. Correct. And the smooth starting and easy operations would be there. Very easy to operate it. Correct. What are the applications? Friction clutches are most popular in four-wheel tractors. So make sure that it is most popular in four-wheel tractors. Your fluid clutch is also used in some tractors these days, but they are not for the for the garden tractors, for the small application, short application, or not heavier application, we are using the fluid clutch. Then the torque clutch is used for the power tillers. To carry out the higher loads, we are using the torque clutch. Correct. And this is all about today. If you wanted to check my previous video, you must subscribe this channel Tiny Steps, must share these videos to your friends so that someone can benefit from it. Thank you and take care.